Good afternoon. I am Admiral Sxena, Chairman Managing Director of Defence PSU Shipyard, named as Garani ShipBuilders and Engineers Limited. The shipyard is located at Kolkata. We are one of the leading shipbuilding, warship building company of the country. We have a distinction of making a large number of warships for both Indian Coast Guard and Indian Navy. We have been with the Ministry of Defence from 1960 onwards, and since then we have delivered 100 warships to both these forces. And you'll appreciate that making such kind of a large number of warships has played a very important role in the maritime security of the nation. I'm happy to inform that on 30th of March this year, the GRSE has got distinction of delivering the 100th warship to the Indian Navy in the form of LCUL-56. And with this, we have become the only shipyard in this country to make such number of warships. The GRSE is a profit-making, dividend-paying company the last 25 years. And also, I must say that we have got other divisions as well. And the GRSE is the only shipyard, I would say, has got the engineering divisions, which produces the various kind of deck machinery equipment which are fitted on board warships of Navy and the Coast Guard. We also make the different kind of portable steel bridges which are primarily meant for supply to the Indian Army and the BRO and many state governments, which can be installed at a short notice in a short period in the most difficult terrains in the different areas, particularly hilly terrains and other areas in different states. We also have the division called the diesel engine plant, where we undertake the assembly, overhauling, repairs of a variety of large powered marine diesel engines, which again goes on board warships. Why we are here in the UK for the DESI? I must say that this shipyard, having got a stature of delivering a large number of ships for the Navy and the Coast Guard, but the government, current government thrust, we are giving a lot of focus on export of the warships to friendly foreign countries. We are focusing on some of the African countries. We are focusing on the countries of the eastern regions, such as Bangladesh, Myanmar, Philippines, Vietnam, and such other friendly countries. We are also looking at Latin American countries. So this DESI provides us a good platform to showcase our capabilities. As I said, that we have made 100 warships, and that 100 warships means there are variety of the warships that have been made, starting from the frigates, to the missile corvettes, to the anti-submarine warfare corvettes, to the landing craft utility ships, to the landing ship tanks, to the offshore patrol vessels, or to the fast moderate attack crafts. Or we talk about the fleet tanker. The only fleet tanker that was built in a country was built by the GRSE. And also we make a lot of small patrol vessels, which are basically supplied to the Ministry of Home Affairs, and they are deployed all across in 7 states of the country. So the GRSE has the capability of making right from 5-ton small boats to up to 24,500 tons of the fleet tanker. So that is the kind of repertoire we have got with us. With this kind of capability, we feel that we have got desired capacities and capabilities, especially the design. I must say that the GRSE has a very strong 100-member design team and a very, very experienced workforce. And it adds up to have a very, very strong and very, I would say, a big modern construction facility, which I call it integrated construction facility, which helps us to bring down the construction period. So that kind of a facilities we have with us. We can have 20 warships construction capacities concurrently. We can make 8 large ships and 12 medium and small ships for different kind of customers, different sizes of ships. We can make it at GRSE concurrently. Now, having this kind of a wherewithal and expertise, we are very much confident that GRSE can provide huge opportunities to various countries who are looking forward for different kind of platforms or design support, all the collaboration. In addition to that, I am also looking around for different kind of major equipment suppliers like Thales, Atlas, and such other suppliers which are there, with whom we are tying up, we are having partnership, who are actually supplying a large number of equipment for various kind of warships which we are making for the Indian Navy and the Coast Guard. So this is another good opportunity to interact with their CEOs, my counterparts, and discuss about the prospects of working together for the future projects as well. I must also say that GRSE has got a very strong order book of 28,000 crores. We are right now constructing 20 ships for the Navy and the Coast Guard. And we have got the orders which we have backed on a competitive bidding basis from the Indian Navy for construction of 4 survey vessel large and 8 ASW shallow water craft. That makes it 12 ships. We are also making 3 stealth missile frigates for the Indian Navy. 3 number is a huge order, 19,000 crore plus rupees of the order for 3 big warships. So all in all, 15 new ships that would be making. That would require a lot of cooperation and collaboration with a variety of equipment suppliers, a lot of other small SMEs and MSMEs, etc., startups. So GRSE is actually going forward in a big way to make sure that we establish a very strong collaborative approach. I'm also looking forward for tying up with friendly, capable shipyards within the country so that we can use their capacity which is available, and we can work together and cut down the build period of the ships so that the customer, that is the Navy and the Coast Guard, can get the ships much more quicker and faster. Similarly, the similar approach I am trying to adopt for our other friendly foreign countries who are looking forward for support from Indian shipyards. So GRSE has got everything with it, and I am trying to portray our capability, which will certainly give a lot of confidence to our customers who can come up and look forward for support from the GRSE.